Good morning, people. How are we doing? This day is stunning. I just texted my mate, who's got the day off from work, and we are off to Brighton. We're off to Brighton because I saw a really, really cool TikTok, and I want to check out if it's still there. It's actually a pizza vending machine, which is some... Really, mate? Don't do that. I'm trying to vlog. Boats, cars, scaffolding, now bikes trying to interrupt me. Oh well. But yeah, there's a pizza vending machine that is just been put at the station, and you can order a pizza and then it comes out all hot and fresh, and it looks amazing. So I'm gonna check out if it's still there and do a TikTok on it. But we're also gonna go to the pier, I think. We'll go down the lanes. We'll just check out Brighton. So, should be fun. So, this is the first time I've worn this cap, and it says Oak on it. It's supposed to be for the baseball team. Baseball team? Yeah, baseball team. But in fact, Oak is my middle name. So I couldn't not buy this. And it's the first time that I'm wearing it, and I kind of like it. Actually, I kind of love it. What is it? There's so much noise in London. Urgh. An iced black coffee.
Oh, we have got ice.
Got no ice. No worries still. Don't worry about it. Day two. Maybe this should be a running series where I just go in and ask for an iced black coffee and see if they give it to me. And then the day that they do, I should get it free or something. Because, yeah, I went in yesterday. The woman was really, really rude to me. She was like, we've got no ice. Costa it is. I know, they have ice. They always have ice. Oh, well, that's good coffee. So, I forgot to get my coffee, which is really annoying. I know I had one just as I got on the tube, but I needed another one because it is warm today. I wanted a nice iced coffee, but this train is an hour long, so I'm going to do some editing. Might even have a little sleep, as I was up until 3 o'clock this morning doing editing because I'm trying to make the vlogs better with the editing. So it's all going well, I think. I added some music into yesterday's vlog, so that was nice. And yeah, we should be at Brighton at about 12:30. And then I'll meet my mate and we'll find this pizza vending machine, which I'm still intrigued by. I can't quite work out if it's actually there still or not. If it's not, I'll find something else to put on my TikTok. But yeah, right this second, I have no idea if it's still there. It would be quite annoying if it wasn't still there. Doesn't look too busy in Brighton today, so that's good. Every time that I come to Brighton, I always think I'm gonna bump into like Zoella or Alfie, or one of them. Oh my god, it is here. Pizza machine's here. Look at the pizza vending machine. This is pretty cool. I'll come back onto that subject in a second. Look at this. What? It's like a proper machine. There's no one inside it, is there? No, there can't be anyone in it. That's really cool. That is really cool. But yeah, every time I come down, because I used to like watch Alfie and everyone vlogging round Brighton, I'm always like, oh yeah, they must be just walking about with their camera. They have to be walking about with their camera, right? Do not worry, we will use the pizza vending machine in a bit when my mate arrives, because I wanted to film a bit for TikTok, and then I'll film the rest of actually getting the pizza, and then I will show you guys how it all works, because it's made by a robot, which is intriguing. I don't know how it cooks it to perfection, apparently. In 4 minutes, which actually seems a lot less time than it should take should take a lot longer to cook a pizza. My mate's gonna be about 20 minutes, so I'm now on the hunt for an iced coffee as I am still half asleep and didn't get a chance to sleep on the train. Probably on the way back I will. But today is an absolute scorcher of a day. This is certainly not Timberland's weather. It's not actually ginger weather, actually. I shouldn't really be out without any sun cream. I'm already turning pink, a bit like a shrimp. A bit like a shrimp. What am I talking about? I'm just walking through the lanes. I love it down here so much, and it's so warm because it's so tight down here. But what's cool is my mate Ella was out in France teaching, and she's been away for 7-8 months, and I thought she was still out there, but she came back on Sunday. So I gave her a call to see how she was, just to have a catch up. She was like, what are you talking about? I'm back in Brighton. So I think we're gonna meet up with her later on, which will be lovely. Have a nice catch up, have a nice drink, and enjoy the sun. How you doing?
I'll give you a hug.
Nice to see you.
How's it going?
Yeah, fine. Should we go and check out this pizza vending machine?
Hell yeah.
Because I'm slightly obsessed.
Perfect.
This pizza is boiling hot. Mate, will you just open that? Look at this pizza. That came out of a vending machine. What is going on? What is going on? It's technology gone mad, eh? Cheers. Let's scram this pizza.
Not bad.
Oh man. Mm. For a pizza made by a robot. Hello. Yeah, London, you need to get on this trend. We need more of these in London.
Robots are good at cooking pizza.
You can't come to Brighton and not go on the pier. It's epic. When I was younger, I always used to come here to the arcades and do like little ticket machines. Spend way too much money and come out with like a toy car and a fake phone. Now I'm a bit older, I still go into the arcades and still spend my adult money on rubbish I don't need. And instead of redeeming the tickets, I just give the tickets away to kids. Because it's, I don't need a toy car and a fake phone. I mean, me and my mate used to come here all the time and just think we were the coolest kids coming to Brighton, playing on the arcade games, winning the jackpot, and then going up to the counter, being like, we have 47,000 tickets, and they were like, great, you can have a toy car and a squishy man. Great, we'll take it. So we've left the pier. We filmed loads of stuff in the arcade, but couldn't hear it because it was too loud. There were loads and loads of people screaming. There was like loads of noise. So it was pretty pointless, but we were gonna go on the British Airways i360, which is this big like viewing platform. But it's 70, actually no, it's £19 to get up for something that goes up and spins and then comes back down. 20 quid. £20. So we're gonna do our next favorite activity in Brighton, which is going to play crazy golf.
No way.
It's not going well so far. I'm on 16 after 4 holes. Great. So I actually have to say that I play normal golf, and putting is like my best part of my game. So when I come to play crazy golf, I should be good. Should is the big word, isn't it?
I think the equipment is the fault.
Yeah, the equipment is also, it's a rubber club, which it's a bit off-putting. And if I used a rubber club on a real golf course, I think I'd be chucked out. So if you get a hole in one, I will buy you an ice cream. That is looking dead on. Nope. Okay. Missed. You owe me an ice cream now.
No.
Yep, that's how it works.
You owe me an
nope,
ice cream.
Nope, that is not how it works. That is definitely not how it works. I defo get a free ice cream from you. Hey dude, why does golfers wear 2 pairs of trousers? In case they get a hole in one.
Oh, God.
It is just there. You could have just read it. I would just like to thank all of my followers, all of my subscribers, and all of my followers on TikTok, as I just got a hole in one. So where's the green jacket? Do you have a green jacket for me? I got a hole in one, so I instantly win. That's the rules. Do you know that your ball was closer than me passing my GCSEs, which wasn't close at all? So this sign says, please leave your clubs handle down in this tub after your game. Just take a look at this. Look at how many people have actually put it handle down.
Oh,
hey mate,
vlogging.
How you doing?
Oh my god, so Ella!
Oh my god! Ella, meet the vlog.
Hi,
vlog
guys.
Meet Ella. So we have come to the Spiegel tent in Brighton. This place is awesome. This is very like Edinburgh-esque. They've got tents over there and they've got a bar back here as well. And it's kind of, I'm pretty sure that this is what they have in Edinburgh as well. The exact same sort of thing with venues and everything. We have just been for a Wagamama's. Always an absolute pleasure, Waggers. If you want to sponsor me, go ahead. Because I am in there too much. We are now just heading for one last drink and then I have to head home, edit this vlog because it's going to be a long one. Caught the sun today, oops. Anyway, so it's currently 12 minutes past one. I'm about to edit this vlog, but something really embarrassing happened on the way back from Brighton. So my carriage had no one in it the whole time. I went to the toilet, came back, still no one there. And it got to like 2 or 3 minutes before getting to London Victoria. And I stupidly put on Dear Evan Hansen, which, as people know, is my favourite musical. I then started singing along, but because I had been talking so much to the vlog and talking to my mates and just having a good laugh, I didn't have a voice. So I was not hitting the notes properly at all. It was all over the place. Anyway, pull into London Victoria. And three people got off my carriage. Three separate people sitting, like, individually to each other. All heard me sing Dear Evan Hansen. What a winner of an end of an evening. Anyway, thank you so much for coming on this journey. I've had such a great day with my mates. I've had such a great time laughing and just relaxing. I forgot how much I love Brighton as well. I probably will do another vlog or three down in Brighton. But for the moment, thank you for coming on these adventures. See yous laters.